I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Hello.
Hello.
Welcome to Saibaba Central School Science Exhibition 2008.
I'm Shravani of Class 8.
And I'm Sayankita of Class 9. Our school organizes Science Fair every year. But this year Science Fair is something special for us because it is a part of our Silver Jubilee celebrations. Our school was founded in 1983 by Sri Sainathan Sarath Babuji, our beloved Guruji. Saibaba Central School is an English medium school which is here in Ongole, Andhra Pradesh. Our school is CBSE affiliated and have children from LKG to 10th standard. This year science exhibition runs over 3 days, that is, it is from 14th to 16th March. We have approximately 350 exhibits in this year's science exhibition. Our science exhibition starts with a model of our new school. This is our school model. In the entrance of our school, we have our prayer hall. The upstairs will be open for public and the downstairs is our school prayer hall.
That is the teaching block. The first level of this block consists of all the labs, such as the computer lab, the maths lab and the science lab. The corner of this level is dedicated to the library. By looking at all these labs and libraries, you can see how much a spirit of inquiry has been fostered into us by our Guruji.
Good morning, my name is K. Nao Sai Krishna. I am from 9th class. My project is Gauss rifle. A Gauss rifle is a magnetic linear accelerator. Means when I am releasing the first ball with no kinetic and no forces apprehend on it, but it is attracted by the first magnet and some kinetic energy will be observed. As it follows, the kinetic energy will be transferred from the magnet to the balls. And the whole process stays continuous. And the second ball is 5 by 8 inch away from it. And the first ball is right in the ground state, so it can't move. And this is how it works.
My head is large, I don't know what it is.
So, when you move here, so the skull is moving.
Yeah.
This will be one of the main use of this. Is you can control the computer by even this software. This is one of the latest ones. This is only the small demo of this. So we can play games with it, and this is a new software.
I'll collect it.
The planetarium is a theater built primarily for presenting educational entertaining shows about astronomy, the night sky, or for training in celestial navigation. A dominant feature of most planetariums is the large dome shaped projection screen offering scenes of stars, planets, and other celestial bodies. When we look at the night sky, many of us will observe stars. Star is a ball of gas that you get by doing that. Sometimes you also find a group of stars forming as constellations. In the sky. There are 88 constellations in our universe. Some of the constellation families are the Zodiac family, the Astrolabe family, and the Indian family.
మండి మది అట్లా అనమాట మండి
ఇక్కడ బండి అనే పదాన్ని సున్నాతో చదివాను అదే సున్నా తీసి ఇలాంటి పదాలు ఇక్కడ ఉన్నాయి చదవండి సార్
చదివాను మండి మడి మండి మది చాలా బాగా చెప్పారు
Save some solar power. There are some of the examples of solar power, such as solar car, fan, and alarm. I'm going to explain about solar cell. Solar cell convert light energy from the help of sun, and it has two types of layers. It is N-type silicon and P-type silicon. In the second type of layer, there is a gap-like structure which fills with electrons and jump from P-type silicon to N-type. Thank you.
From a distance, you ask.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to
myself.
Wow.
They have a beginning, they have an end.
So actually every child has a question in front of them because we're trying to get them to understand that science starts well, it starts with a question, you know, and desire to know something. Many children think science is just something they read in the textbook and they're not understand, they don't understand the process.
Simultaneously, you put six, number six, see what will happen. Do it. No, it's in the shoe also, you can do it.
Going you, six times, yeah?
No, sir, no, madam. You rotate this finger clockwise. Simultaneously, you put six. Clockwise, you rotate this finger. Simultaneously, you mark six with finger. No, it becomes anti-clockwise. The moment you put this finger, it becomes anti-clockwise.
Why?
I don't know. Some orthopedic has sent me an email. I'm just repeating it.
To our beloved Amakaru Festival, who guides us day to day with their kind and wise counsel. And I would like to welcome our chief guest, Dr. Jagadish Garu, who is a renowned scientist and head the Center of Ecology and Sustainable Resources at RMK Engineering College in Tamil Nadu.
When I was a child, when I was your age, there's a great kid song and it was called What a Wonderful World. What a Wonderful World. I see more of this, what you have actually shown, what we can learn about, what we can discover, many, many wonders around us in this world and in, within us and around us that we can discover, which is the very purpose of learning and of school, of education.
I must say,
It's been a fantastic experience to be here and to be part of, involved in all of this. What a wonderful display you have set up. For me, science has always been a mixture of some of the elements that Yvonne talked about, of that spirit of inquiry, that willingness to look into things in a deeper way. And what I'm also so happy to see is the aspect of artistry there too.
As Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru used to say, scientific temper is needed for a country like ours. Just imagine, one Edison could transform the whole world with lighting and other applications.
In my presentation, I would like to show you how many of the inventions have been adopted from Mother Nature. Many a time we think that everything is created in the laboratory, but nature is the biggest laboratory nature has provided us, where we can get many solutions. In fact, most of the discoveries and inventions have emanated from nature. Here you find on the left the aeroplane, but the aeroplane has this origin from the flight of the bird. How the bird changes its wings to change the direction, how it dives, all this has emanated from by studying the various habits of this bird. For example, the camera, which we every day use, it has its origin from the function of the eye. How the eye receives the images and how we see the things. That was the starting point for the invention of this camera. The radar, for example, radar works on the principle of the bat. Bat, you know, in the dark, it sends signals and out of sight it comes back. That's the principle used in the radar. Next one. For example, computer. Computer has its origin from the brain. How the brain functions, how the brain stores knowledge and how it retrieves. That's the origin for the invention of this computer.
Let us now take a brief tour of all the exhibits. The first section is a physics section. Let's have a look at all the magnetism experiments. This is a maglev tray.
Now I am showing my project is about magnetic current, or else it is called as magnetic levitation. Magnetic suspension is a method by which an object is suspended with no support. You can see from the glasses. See, I am keeping object. See, without touching the track, the object is going fast.
Train. This shows us how magnetism can be used for our benefit. A maglev train can travel up to 581 kilometers per hour. We are coming to what can be called the oxygen of the modern world, electricity. Now, Shin, can you please demonstrate your exhibit?
This is the exhibit known as Jacob's Ladder. Here we can see the spark originating at the lower part of the copper wire and dancing its way upwards. This happens because the copper wires connected to the transformer creates potential difference of 10,000 volts. The spark creates extreme hot gases as it goes up and lights the colder around it.
We are in the biology section of the exhibition. Here many aspects of the study of living organisms are explored. This was the prize-winning NCSE project of this year. This dealt with the soil macrofauna diversity that is present inside the soil and helps the farmers in the soil. But we came to know that these organisms are getting lost due to use of chemical fertilizers and pesticides.
Every year we have been conducting exhibition, but this year in a large scale we are doing it because it is our silver jubilee of the school. Therefore, we have been doing it in a larger scale and a grand manner. And the parents have helped us in preparing the good exhibits, and the teachers and the staff have overworked for putting up a better show. And I thank all the staff for their endeavor in showing a better performance of the exhibition. I equally feel that I should express my gratitude towards the press and media who have helped in giving a wide publicity and coverage.
This is chemistry session. Now, my friend Sanjay is going to explain his experiment.
Experiment name is instant blood using chemical. Take two test tubes with water. In first test tube, add 1 spoon of potassium thiocyanate. In second test tube, add 1 spoon of ferric chloride. Now pour potassium thiocyanate solution on her. Due to the reaction of potassium thiocyanate and ferric nitrate, the red color will appear and form like a blood. Thank you.
Science is not only the area which she is exploring in our exhibition, but we also demonstrate many areas which can be explored in this exhibition. Now we are in mathematics section. Mathematics can be applied analytically to rational expressions. Now, here is my friend Satvika, who is going to explain us about abacus. Satvika, can you please explain your experiment?
Good afternoon. My name is Satvika. I am of class 4. I would like to say about abacus. This is abacus. You can ask me any sum in 4 digit additions, 2 digit into 1 digit multiplications, 3 digit divides, 1 digit divisions and 4 digit subtractions. You can ask me any sum. This shows that suppose 4 plus 8, that is 12. Thank you.
Now let me introduce my friends.
Hello, I am Rishi of class 9.
Hello, I am Dheeraj of class 9th, and our project is about rockets and satellites, and we are working together as a team on this project. A rocket is a machine which is used for taking satellites as well as the humans into the space for their research work. And a satellite is a transmitting machine which is used for transmitting the information from the Earth and again sends the information to different parts on the Earth and finding the information happenings on the Earth and in the space. Thank you.
Now, we are in the social session. We have many history subjects and geography subjects. We have states and capitals. We have Indus Valley civilizations. Now, my friend Amrita is going to explain her exhibit. Hi, Amrita. Can you explain your exhibit?
Good afternoon. My name is Amrita Harika of third class. My project is about states and capitals. It is an educational quiz game to improve knowledge. It is very easy to play. First of all, choose one state from the upper part.
I chose Goa.
Next, choose the correct capital to the state from the lower part.
I chose Hyderabad.
Now, let us check if your answer is correct or not. Oh no, please draw again.
Okay. I chose Panaji.
Wow, correct. Placing the plug pins upper and lower. If there is a sound and a light, our answer is correct. Thank you.
In our school science exhibitions, we give equal preference to languages also. So in this section, we also use our spirit of inquiry in knowing the construction and the uses of languages. So in this English section, the young children have demonstrated the phonics system and also regarding the use of punctuation and parts of speech. Hello, Shweta, will you please tell us regarding your exhibit?
I'm going to explain you about a paragraph. A paragraph is a set of sentences that is related to the same topic. I'll show you now. And it divides up the story as if within a paragraph. You know this story of Cinderella?
Yes.
You can keep in the order?
Sure.
Good. Now you can match the sentences also.
I shall try.
Good. You kept all correct. Right. Now I'll take these sentences and we'll make a paragraph. Before we use it as these sentences, as a sentences. Now we are using as a paragraph. We have to take all in line wise. This is a paragraph now we done from the sentences. Thank you.
Now we are coming to information technology section of our science exhibition. Computer education has always been an important part of Saibaba Central School's school curriculum. This exhibit here shows us the various internal components of a computer. The second exhibit here shows us three operating systems, namely Windows, Mac and Linux. The third exhibit shows us various computer storage devices. This exhibit here shows us various networking devices. This exhibit demonstrates various printers. This is an inkjet, this is a dot matrix and a laser printer. This exhibit here shows us that internet has revolutionized communication. This is a demonstration of various laptops, desktops and CPUs. This is a sophisticated program called Google Earth, which allows us to see any part of the world. And this is a questionnaire to test our knowledge. Now I'm going to take a small test. Yes.
Hello, my name is Rishikesh. I am in class 4th. My experiment name is Test Your Knowledge. Can you please test your knowledge?
Sure, I'll try it.
Congratulations.
I have finally won in this questionnaire after coming to the computer section.
Every minute and every